6 years ago or so, I said, I'm going to take a sabbatical from the air travel. Now I just say that, sorry, I don't want to fly. That's it.
So then the assignment goes away, or do you still do it?
No, I lose it. That's it. It's okay. And you know, most of these are what I've already done, juries and some meetings and some seminars. Theek hai yaar, kitna karoge zindagi mein?
Thank you so much for having us here. What a beautiful home, and I think it's really a privilege to be here with you. Thank you for having
Sibani,
us.
You people have come all the way from Mumbai. Thank you very much for that.
Now today you're the master of sustainability.
No, I'm not. And I don't like the word sustainable. There's nothing which is sustainable. Cost, culture and climate.
Okay.
Whatever we do should be cost conscious, climatically appropriate and culturally conforming.
So I would like to actually understand how you tackle your first principle about climate. This is about your personal story.
This is a climate. So basically, I'm a reluctant consultant. Consultancy is not my first love. So
you'd rather write?
Yes. Education and writing. The cost, culture, climate is what are the founding principles we believe in.
Right.
But sometimes it doesn't happen as good as we want. But we try.
How flexible then is the material board? Because materiality is one of your...
That's one of the strengths of the office.
Okay.
We have worked with mud, clay, stone, bamboo, exposed bricks, normal bricks. We have worked with different kind of roof forms. We worked with different elements of architecture. Verandas, skylights, courtyards, roofs, pavilions, covered walls, covered roofs, flowing spaces. Everything that we have done, except for some of the recent ideas, everything's in the public realm. But the point is reaching out to people. And the builders who have worked with us in the last 26, 27 years of practice, more than 100 contractors have worked with us.
Wow.
It's a mind-boggling number.
That's
many
huge.
Of them we have not repeatedly worked with them. Fine, but if they are going and working with some other project for some other owner, even if they use 5% of alternative ideas, my job is done.
So I'm not here. The word far
yes.
More.
So I'm not here to promote Sathya Consultants. So if someone wants any of the ideas that we have used, they need not come to us. They can go to any source. That way I'm like Laurie Baker. I'm influenced by Laurie Baker. Laurie Baker never held his knowledge to himself.
True.
So later on, as you all know, if someone wanted a Laurie Baker ideas, they didn't have gone to Laurie Baker. They could have gone to anyone else and
yes.
Got to the house.
Yes, the whole series of people.
That's how we have been working. They need not come to us.
So, but you were saying that if someone wants to approach you to understand all of this.
Yeah, if someone approaches by some, let's say they hear by word of mouth, or they see a house on the roadside, they knock at the door and they get our number, they come to us. Or they read my article, they come to us. Whoever calls are invariably called to the office with no exception. If they don't choose to come, their choice.
Okay.
So they come to the office, we share slides with them. And this has started right in 90s. I had a slide projector and I used to take a lot of slide photographs in those days. And whatever early houses we designed, I would keep a set of slides. I'll show them on a small little wall in my small office in those days. And I will say, these are the houses we have done. Please go and see them. Seeing the house, walking into the house, experience, that was another value.
That was the other thing which I was
that's
just
a must,
coming
must and shoot.
To.
Okay. Unless experience, no way we can proceed. So we do that, then we say, look, go around, look around. And invariably, I would also mention the names of the other architects in Bangalore. So I keep mentioning these names to them on the first or second meeting. I say, look, I am not the only one. There are many other architects who do very good work. Please approach them. Then you choose whom you want to go to.
Right.
So, I mean, I know these are all old world values, but I somehow continue to believe in these old world values. And then they
that
go
is sustainability,
and then
it?
They go around looking at the houses, and if they like it, they come back to us, or they may go to other architects, fine with us. As I said earlier, architect is immaterial to me. Architecture is important to me. Even if I lose a project in the process, I don't mind that happening around. So after all that, they come back to us. Then we speak about these values and other things, and the plan making starts. We don't make any, we don't do any 3D, you know, images, no animation, nothing. Even today we don't. The plan making is the first step, two-dimensional. Then we make a three-dimensional hand-drawn axonometric view of the whole house. showing the roof forms, because we work a lot on roof forms also.
Okay.
We believe in roof forms. Then a cardboard model is done. So that's a massing. So we have two dimension, we have three dimension, then your massing and volume studies.
Right.
So it takes a good 1.5 to 3 months to evolve a house in the process. So long drawn process and lots and lots of dialoguing, lots of revisions, because end of the day they live in the house.
Right. A current problem in the country, we have a huge housing shortage, and not too many, I mean the way, the kind of shortfall that is going, the demand and supply gap, it is only getting bigger and bigger. Of course, developers do develop a lot of stuff which is not going out. Do you see that we can actually ever solve the problem if we're customizing to this level?
If I'm a good cook and if someone tells me, Sathya, there is a huge problem of hunger, I can maximum cook for maybe 10, 20, 50, 100.
Right.
I can't cook for a million people. Now, isn't it possible? It's possible. Now, maybe we have some, as a firm, we have some ideas about mass housing. We don't work with the governments. There's only two in our life, and both have been extremely bad experiences. I don't know how architects manage the governments. But you see, most of the issues that you're talking about comes to governance.
Right.
Our
like
firm,
you were talking
our
about
firm has some, our right. firm has some ideas, some solutions. But if we have to carry them out, we have to work with the government.
Right.
And as a firm, we are against working with the government because both the experience have been extremely terrible. Both have been extremely terrible experiences.
I was asking you more in terms of, you know, when you're talking of responsible architecture and you're trying to actually, you are contributing in a positive way to how the globe can, you know,
precisely,
work.
But
so then therefore our country and, you
precisely,
know,
but
the
then where is the opportunity of scaling
faces?
It up? Government, NGOs, institutions. Both our government projects were extremely terrible. Maybe I don't know how to work with the government.
Probably.
Now, next is the NGOs. The issue with the NGO, we have done a lot of NGO work at a smaller scale. See, as it is, we run one of those what I call as a middle class firm. And I use the word.
Like an NGO.
Yeah, I use the word actually. I say we work with the middle class. Even today, people with 30 lakhs, 40 lakhs, 50 lakhs budget come to our firm in Bangalore. Whereas many, many firms today refuse anything less than a crore.
Right.
We still work with 40 lakh, 50 lakh budget. So we are a middle class firm. And you know, if you start working with the NGO where they are not able to pay the fees, it will be extremely difficult for us. If we, if as a firm, if you have done enough money, I know of architects who do pro bono and you know they claim that they do pro bono work, which is very good. I am very proud of them. But we are not in a position to do pro bono work.
Yeah.
Okay. So it's back into again what kind of life you want to lead. So for us or for me individually, it's not merely running an eco-friendly firm on sustainable, whatever you people call as. I do believe we should live what nowadays I'm calling is a PRC, personal resource consumption. We all need to reduce our PRC, our personal resource consumption. More the money, higher the resource consumption. Very simple rule there.
Yeah, but traditionally, I think Indians, we have believed in that. That is a very strong belief.
Absolutely,
of our traditions.
Yes. Just yesterday, I read a little
frugality.
Article about Steve Jobs.
Right.
And you know, somewhere, I believe a lot of people have been talking about the carbon footprint of the CEOs of companies. I don't want to question governments, I don't want to question multinationals, I don't want to question market. I'm just now looking at what am I doing to that.
Right.
That's all I'm looking at the moment. What is my personal resource consumption, PRC?
Right.
Now, tomorrow I may get some high profile clients, they may pay us more fee, I may make more money than I need, I may offer pro bono, then I may say I'm here to solve the social housing problem. But then what happened? The moment I make more money, I don't think the money I'm making will not only and only go for pro bono.
Surely.
I'll definitely buy a 15 lakhs car. I'll definitely go on more foreign holiday trips. Family trips are unavoidable. They're unavoidable. But other than family trips, my flights in the last 6 years has reduced by 90%.
That's phenomenal.
Nowadays, I don't stay in hotels. I stay with friends. And I call upon friends. If I don't get a friend to stay with, then only I stay in a hotel. And if I have to stay in a hotel, I have a cap. I don't want to stay in a hotel more than 1,000 rupees a night hotel.
Okay.
See, because today major problem in sustainability is because of affordability.
True.
If you see who are the people who are consuming maximum of the earth resources, they are people who can afford to spend.
Exactly.
And what is that? It's earth's money, it's not our and your money.
Yeah, I think, you know, across the globe what we notice is they're talking of reducing wastage at the production level. But why produce so much in the first place?
In the first place.
And there are so many choices and things come from the farthest corner of the world when you have everything available right there, and which actually is much more beneficial because it's what is given to us.
You have seen my TEDx talk, right. And the first thing is that why do we need all this to lead a happy and content life?
Right.
But see, these are very, very personal thoughts. I'm not trying to say others, my family or my office colleagues or my professional colleagues should agree with me.
Yeah.
End of the day, it's like, you know, you lead your life, that's it.
Right. You've been talking about, you know, your personal consumption patterns and, you know, the resource consumption. But obviously, you are also a big influence in the industry. And I think students and, you know, the younger generation also look up to you.
The reference to PRC, personal resource consumption, is not about living a life of poverty.
Surely.
It's not. The CEO of a company can reduce his or her resources by as much as possible.
True.
Maybe skip at least 5 flights and manage by a Skype discussion. Maybe. So they're all now, I'm just now trying to talk about human action, but not about other humans.
The
concern at the moment is about what am I doing.
Same.
You know, the TEDx talk which you said, am I responsible? And I'm saying, yes, I am responsible for what's happening in Japan or America, wherever. It's again not a new thought. People have said it, butterfly effect.
Right.
So I'm just saying, you know, I'm a butterfly. If I flutter my wings, something will happen elsewhere. So let me not do that.
I've heard that you've decided not to travel. And
This started about 7 years ago.
Okay.
The idea of shunning air travel, old enough. Now I just say that, sorry, I don't want to fly. That's it.
So then the assignment goes away, or do you still do it?
No,
like
I lose it. Okay. I lose it. That's it. It's okay. And you know, most of these are what I've already done, juries and some meetings and some seminars. Okay, kitna karoge zindagi mein? So this whole thing is a personal call. If someone cannot avoid flights, go. I'm not trying to say don't fly. But wherever we can, that's all one request is, wherever we can. Even here, I am not here to influence others. I am doing what I can. There are some solutions. I am not saying it is the solution, but it may work.
Right. So thank you so much for your time, for having us here.
Yes.
This conversation could go on forever, I think. And there are a lot of other, you know, sub-points that I would have loved to touch upon, but we are limited with other issues. So thank you once again.
Thank you, Sibani. Thank you. And it's a pleasure to sit and, you know, when someone says, come and have a cup of, you know, just let's chat it over chai. What more you need?
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
It's my pleasure.
This.